I would like to invite you to listen to the message from the Minister for Digitalization of the Netherlands, Alexandra van Huffelen, who couldn't join us today because she is in the Caribbean. But please.
Ladies and gentlemen, although I'm unable to be in Brussels today, I'm happy to take you through the developments in the Netherlands. We are determined to base digitalization on a strong foundation of public values, like democracy, safety, privacy, transparency, and self-determination. Based upon these values, we've developed a practical and nationwide working agenda, which works towards clear goals. For example, a digital world which is trustworthy for all, and a value-based and transparent digital government. Transparency and openness foster trust and are the basis for reuse and enable citizens to check on us. Therefore, our policy is for the government to be transparent and work as open as possible, including open policies, open data, and also open source, unless it's absolutely necessary to do otherwise. However, this starting point has not been sufficient enough to get open source working up and running. It's not that people don't want to. On the contrary, these principles of transparency, reusability and cooperation are broadly supported by officials and civil servants. The problem is that they require new ways of working and thinking. Besides, open source is too often seen as a technical term, and this creates the misunderstanding that practical dilemmas should be left to engineers. It should be seen as a task for the whole organization. And openness of information needs to be broadly accepted, archiving rules and internal frameworks. Too often, our challenge is found in a culture of closeness within government organizations, but it takes time to change cultural habits. In order to achieve this, we work on the following. First, we're setting up an open source program office, OSPO, within my ministry. This office will boost open source working, remove any obstacles, and draw up internal frameworks. Naturally, we've been inspired by the OSPOs of several other member states and the one within the European Commission. Building on this, my ambition is to strengthen the OSPO efforts for the entire national government. Secondly, we're placing this investigation firmly within the bounds of our renewed Freedom of Information Act. The source code of government software is government information. That makes that it falls under the reach of this law. So we recently published the source code of the Dutch Digital Identity App. Thirdly, we're training and fostering awareness among government professionals. In this way, we make open source a standard. These practical steps will help us to build a value-based, transparent digital government that is trusted by citizens. And we aim to work closely on the European stage. For example, within the European OSPO network, or by jointly developing cross-border digital services. I hope that today's summit will contribute to greater collaboration and a more trusted digital sphere. Simply put, an open source Europe. Thank you.